All right, well, the Patrik Berglund saga in Buffalo continues. Today, the Sabres have placed him on unconditional waivers with the intent to terminate his contract. He's got 3 years after this one remaining and a total of over $12 million owed between now and the following 3 years. If you haven't been following this story, this sort of all really started snowballing when he was suspended by the team. He missed a practice, then missed a flight.
He was suspended for failing to report. He started the chain,
yes,
not the team.
Yes, exactly. So that's where it started. Mm-hmm. What do you make of what's happened now? And more importantly, the termination of the contract changes things for the Sabres in terms of the money that they can spend on other players. How so?
Yeah, well, I mean, it'll give them more money to spend for Jeff Skinner, for example. When his contract is up at the end of the year, they can start talking or announce something if they want to after January 1st as a player who was traded in the final year of his contract. So gives them a little bit more option there. I got to say, though, this is a strange story because $12 million, Mike, that's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money.
Absolutely.
So he doesn't like Buffalo.
I ran the totals, and Patrik Berglund's done quite well in his career. He's made about 20 already.
Yeah.
But he hasn't made so much that you can scoff at 12. So he's basically walking away from that because he dislikes Buffalo so much that he'd rather forego $12 million and maybe go somewhere else and make way less money, or over to Europe and make
so
less money.
It's so weird with how the Sabres are doing.
Well, absolutely.
Yeah, they're having success.
The interesting part of this is that it's kind of been reported out there is that he had a 20-team no-trade list.
So While he was a Blue.
He had to put that list in on June 30th last summer.
Yeah.
And so that'd be 20 teams. And with all due respect to Buffalo, and I will say firsthand, the people who play in Buffalo love Buffalo. But last summer, you didn't know if Buffalo was going to be very good.
Yeah.
True.
You wouldn't put them on just about... Virtually no player would put them in their top 11 teams.
Okay.
Cup contender, sexy city, good weather, no tax, whatever it might be, unless you're from that area.
Yeah.
It appears as though there was a bit of a snafu between Patrik Berglund, his agent, and the team in putting that list in a timely manner. So he didn't have the no trade protection, from what we understand, that he otherwise earned with that contract. So now that allowed St. Louis to trade them anywhere he wanted.
Yeah.
And he was traded, if I'm not mistaken, on July 1st.
On July 1st.
The next day.
In the Ryan O'Reilly
trade. That he would have otherwise not been able to be traded to Buffalo had Buffalo been on the list. So,
again, though, that's not the fault of the Buffalo Sabres.
No.
You know, that's what's weird to me about the whole thing.
Well, without being rude to Patrik Berglund, Buffalo's happy about this.
Well, yeah, because like they mentioned, they have money.
They want out of that contract.
Yeah.
They are happy to be rid, not Patrik Berglund, the person, or even the player, but that contract. And so the fact that he was willing to walk away, terminate the contract, and they can get away free and clear and have that money freed up and that roster spot freed up, that probably works out just fine for the Buffalo Sabres. And hopefully for Patrik Berglund, he'll relatch on somewhere else, go enjoy playing hockey once again, and don't worry about the money.
Is he going to make $12 million over the next 3 years on the free agent market?
No, he will not.
I don't think he will.
And I can't imagine what that conversation is going to be like between him and his agent, if that's the case.
Oh, I know what it's going to be like. It'll be short.
It'll
be really short.
I'll be asking for a refund for the money I paid you for the previous 10 years.
Yeah, well, that will be between his lawyer and the agent's lawyer. But the original conversation will be, you, my friend, are fired.
But it's still
there's either a divorce that already happened.
But the point still remains. He hated Buffalo or disliked Buffalo for whatever reason enough to do what you just talked about.
Yeah, wow.
Well, once he clears waivers, I believe that's the correct terminology, I'm sure there will be teams that will have interest in him.
Yeah, maybe.